Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you another new Arduino project. This is a smart timetable which can be configured according to the user's requirement. User can select the school items according to his timetable and configure the system according to that. Books and other school items are having RFID tags and they are helpful to detect the particular item for the system. And also it can be tracked by the user through his mobile phone, and that will be helpful if the bag is lost or stolen. So, before going for the detailed explanation, I invite you to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon to get the future videos like this. So, let's power on the system through the power switch. It displays the project name and initializes the internal components like GSM and GPS modules. In the home screen, we can see the current date and time. There are four main buttons in the system. Let's see their functionalities. The upper yellow color keys are used to do left and right navigations in the menu. The red button is used to enter for the menu and select items. Blue button is used as the back key in the menu navigation. So this is the menu navigation flow of the system. When we first enter the menu by clicking red button, it will show all 7 days in a week. User can navigate left and right in the menu and select one day by clicking the red button again. After that, he will be able to see the list of school items. User can navigate left and right in the menu to mark items related to that day. A star icon will appear in front of the selected items. These timetable configurations will be saved in the EEP ROM of the Arduino IC. So even we restart the system, it will not erase the configurations. This is how to enter main menu and navigate left and right to choose a day. After choosing the day, we can see all school items inside it by navigating left and right. We can use red button to select or deselect school items for the particular day. After the configuration, user can use blue button to navigate back to the home screen again. So let's see how an actual scenario works for the current date of the system. According to the system, current date is Thursday. I will enter to the menu and navigate to the Thursday. And inside it, I will select maths and racket items. Then I will come back to the home screen. Let's scan the RFID tag of the racket. It accepts by the system because we have selected it for today from the timetable. It will reject science RFID tag because it is not selected for today. Maths book will be accepted by the system according to our configurations. Let's edit the items of the timetable for today and check another scenario again. Let's select only science book and deselect all other items. Then it will only accept science book and rejects all other items. we can track this device using the SMS service. When we send a SMS to the system's SIM card by typing location, the system will reply the current location of the bag. Then we can copy these coordinates and paste it in the Google Maps to see it in the map. Let's open the system enclosure and observe the inside components. This is the ATmega328 IC which is used in Arduino boards. We are only using this IC instead of a whole Arduino board to reduce the space and shrink the size of the circuit. This is a SIM800 GSM module which is very small and easy to use. I have done separate tutorials about this module and I will include the links for them in the description. This is a DS1302 RTC clock module which is used to run the clock of the system. This is the MFRC522 RFID reader which is used to read the RFID tags. This buzzer is used to generate the notification tones. These three regulators are used to create the required voltages to run the system components. This new 6M GPS module is used to get the current location data for the system. A 16x2 LCD screen has used to display the system data and it is driving by a I2C LCD adapter. Two LED indicators are there and four buttons have connected to the circuit like this. So this is a brief explanation about my system. See you soon from my next video. Thanks for watching and subscribing my channel.